Tuesday. Furthermore, the participants of the Helen Keller Challenge will be allowed to have an earlier hands-on experience of what they will go through in the challenge. Helen Keller Challenge is actually a series of activities which my third speaker Julie will elaborate on.
Good morning, teachers and fellow TPJs. I'm Shuk, and on my part, I'm going to explain the Helen Keller Challenge. The Helen Keller Challenge is a series of activities that resembles an amazing race. Participants will have to go through a series of 4 checkpoints and 2 quizzes. And these quizzes and checkpoints will test them on several aspects of difficulties that Helen Keller faces. The objective of this challenge is to allow participants to experience the various difficulties that Keller faced during the course of a lifetime. In doing so, we are able to enhance the participants' knowledge on Helen Keller. As such, they would then appreciate Helen Keller's work and develop a further sense of curiosity as to what she did during her lifetime. Therefore, the project objective of showcasing Helen Keller's work would have been achieved. Also, by experiencing Helen Keller's difficulties, participants will be inspired by Helen and obtain certain qualities such as patience, endurance, and also perseverance. We decided to do an amazing race-like activity because this is in response to the survey we made regarding the participants' preference of activity. As stated in the pie chart, interactive games proved to be the third most preferred activity. Furthermore, as the percentage of surveys stated that as 90% of surveys stated that they would very much like to experience living in Helen Keller's world. Thus, combining the two surveys, the Helen Keller Challenge is created. Next is the Helen Inspires Awards. It is actually a competition requiring participants to design a puma and quote by and with a quote by Helen Keller written on it. Judging for the competition would be based on participants' creativity in putting together the quote and the design. They will be allowed to use references from the exhibition only. We decided to do this activity in response to the observance made previously in Sydney, Australia. During the observance, students were required to write an essay about the impact of Helen Keller on their lives. The activity proved to be a successful one in spreading the message of Helen Keller, especially among the young. Thus, we decided to hold a puma competition instead, requiring them to use more of their creativity. Furthermore, the award intends to stir deeper into participants' hearts rather than just touch the surface. Next, I would like to pass on this presentation to the fourth speaker, Hui Song, to explain more about the evaluation and conclude the presentation.
Good morning, everyone. I will be discussing on the benefits and limitations of our project. Firstly, our project will let our targeted audience, students, have a better understanding and more compassion towards the disabled. Our exhibition and the Helen Keller Challenge will let our audience understand the hardship that the disabled went through rather than receive education that most students take for granted. Students learn to have more compassion for the disabled. Next, our puma making competition, Helen Keller Inspires. They also let students reflect on Helen Keller's work and be inspired by the post and therefore making the puma for the competition. I'll be evaluating on the limitations of our project. Firstly, as our targeted audience is mainly students from TJC, the venue of our exhibition chosen will be the school hall that is accessible for students. work. So our whole project will be held in one weekend in order to avoid these days of students. The cost of our whole project will be relatively low, and most of them will come from the sales of wristbands during the Helen Challenge. As for Duma making competition, we will invite experienced art teachers from our own college to judge for the competition. These teachers will be easily available as the event is held in school. In conclusion, Helen has produced a dramatic shift in the perception of the connection towards disabled. The purpose of our project showcase Helen Keller's contributions and let students learn the positive attitude and great qualities that she has. And I believe that our project have achieved that. Our events have been fully planned in many aspects in terms of manageability, visibility, and accessibility. Therefore, I believe that our project is successful.
Speak louder, because some of you start speaking louder and then you know gradually become softer. Wow, very hard. So can you try to project your voice?
Good morning, everyone. My name is Yu Jing Ting. Today, my group and I from TP117 will be presenting our project. Our group members are Lai Zhongming, Yeo Kishuan, and Lin Ho. Okay, first, I'll be the first presenter for today, followed by Dean, who is the second speaker. This one, the third, and Chong will be the last speaker. I will be covering on the overview and the introduction. So here are the contents. There are the overview, introduction, contributions and impact, series of events, and conclusion. What I'll be covering will be the overview and the introduction. Now, our groundbreaker for today will be Archimedes, who is a physicist, mathematician, and inventor. He has came up with various theories and discoveries which will lead to improvement in people's lives. So our showcase, we decided that it will be an innovation week. So now I'll be going on into the introduction of the project. So what has he done? What's his role as a groundbreaker? He has crafted the basic technological foundations that will make people's life easier and convenient to live in. Such as, for example, in construction sites, there will be pulleys and such to lift up heavy work. That is what I mean by easier life. And there's also efficient way of doing things, and hence entertainment such as the Stomachion and the theory of flotation which introduced hot air balloon, though he did not create the hot air balloon. Now, what are his contributions? The major contributions that we decided to showcase will be the Archimedes rule, the principle of rotation, the lift system, which is a theory. Next, what do we hope to achieve at the end of the project? We would like our audiences to recognize his work. We will also want to prevent his discoveries from being neglected such that if such things happen, it will fall into obscurity if we do not do this showcase. And we should also be grateful for his current standard of living that he has given us through his contributions. And lastly, we want our audiences to know that by learning through his contributions, we can let them benefit that they can enjoy success with passion and through hard work.